Hi everyone, I am going to show you some quick tips for editing your YouTube automatic captions. So I'm here at YouTube and I have already uploaded a video that I made with Screencast-O-Matic, and then I waited. You have to wait some time for YouTube to add the automatic captions. So just be patient with that. And then I'm going to click on my profile image and go to YouTube Studio. And then along the left-hand side of the screen, I'm going to click videos, and then I'm going to scroll to find my video, and I'm going to click on the video that I want to caption, and then from here I will click on subtitles on the left hand side, and then here is my caption track. I can see that it has already been created and it's automatic, and I want to click the three dot icon and then click edit on Classic Studio. And we're going to edit the automatic track, which, as you can see, as it appears here, it doesn't have any capitalization or sentence punctuation, periods, commas, etc. And so that would be hard for somebody to understand if they were reading it. And there's also some typos and little things to fix. So I'm going to click edit. And what I do is I just do a quick run through and I add the capital letters that I need and the periods that I need because I kind of know where they should be. And that can go really quickly. So I literally just click in and start capitalizing things and adding sentence punctuation and fixing any misspellings I notice. So it misspelled my last name. That's very common for YouTube to not know how to spell your name. So you want to fix that because that would be pretty embarrassing to have your name misspelled. So I've made some edits, and you're literally going to run through and fix everything. You might have to click into every little box and fix it depending upon your sentences. Make sure to make it legible and intelligible for somebody reading it. And you can press play and listen to yourself talking if you can't really remember what you said and what should be there. And then when you're all done making your edits, run through the whole transcript and edit everything, then click Save Changes. And then after it saves, you'll see that it's publishing. And after it's done publishing, so let's see, you can go back to the automatic track and delete it. So I can click English Automatic. This takes me back to that track that existed before I made my edits, and I can unpublish it. Click unpublish, and then click delete. And that will delete the automatic track, so my students only have access to the one that I edited, the English track. Okay, let us know if you have any questions.